stuff. I just finished the most wonderful story about a beanstalk and an ogre and...
That's not. Marie, again, where are you going? Don't talk about her father that way.
My father is not crazy. He's a genius.
Into the woods and bring me back the biggest, healthiest deer you can find.
But I hate the woods.
Just get me a deer for my wedding feast.
Wait, Gaston, you know I hate the woods. It's dark, it's spooky, and there's bugs and spiders.
Ah! Papa, are you all right?
I'm fine, but I can't for the life of me figure out why that happened. If this isn't the stubbornest piece of... Ow!
Papa!
I'm about ready to give up on this hunk of junk.
Oh, you always say that.
I mean it this time. I'll never get this boneheaded contraption to work.
Of course you will. No one first tries the fair tomorrow and become a world-famous inventor.
You really think so?
You know I do. I always have.
Well, we better get cracking. This thing's not going to fix itself. Now, let me see. Where did I put that dog-legged puncher?
Papa.
So tell me, did you have a good time in town today?
I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Well, they take me to wonderful places where there's adventure and mystery and romance and happy endings. Papa, if I asked you something, would you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
My God, odd. Now where would you get an idea like that?
Well, I don't know. It's just that, well, people talk.
They talk about me, too. No, I'm not odd, nor you. No family ever saner, except one uncle who, well, maybe not that nice. And all you say and do, you couldn't make me plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, and you can take my word. You are the creme de la creme. No matter what you do, I'm on your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
No matter what they say, you make me proud. I love the funny way you stand up from the crowd.
It's my intention, my invention shows the world out there one day just what we've got.
No matter what.
Now some may say all fathers just exaggerate.
That every daughter's great.
You are.
And every daughter tends to say her father's tops.
She pulls out all the stops to praise him, and quite rightly. No matter what the pay, we've come this far. And I pray that you remain exactly as you are. There's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. You're never strange.
Don't ever change.
You're all I've got. No matter what.
Now, what do you say we give her a try?
All right.
Right, stand back. Here we go.
So simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design will be my old age pension. That is providing I can find the fair at all. I must have missed a sign. I should have paid attention.
Drop it!
That's not a nightingale and not a mating call.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Oh, hello.
That's it. This has gone far enough. I'm in charge here, and I say that he's gone.
How would you like a nice, hot cup of tea? It'll warm you right up in no time, sir.
Oh, yes, please.
No, no tea. We'll be here all night. No tea.
This is just what I need.
There you are.
I think I scared him, Mama.
Hey there, little fellow. What's your name?
Chip.
Figures.
Care for a blanket, what's you?
I just love older men.
I bet you're always just trying to make me jealous. But it's not going to work this time.
Me? What about you? Simone?
Jacques?
Michelle?
Pierre?
Véronique?
Louis, listen to me. You've got to get him out of here. Do you have any idea what the master will do if he finds out you let a stranger?
Calm yourself, Cosworth. The master will never have to know. Haven't you? No, I was merely looking for a place to stay!
I'll give you a place to stay!